Hello, dear chess fans. My name is Eugene Greenis. Welcome to my free chess school, from beginners to advanced, open for everyone who want to improve own game. This video with some tactical exercises is intended for the beginners. There are some practical opening rules for beginners, which are usually worth remembering. These rules are: 1. Open with either the e pawn or the d pawn. 2. Wherever possible, make a good developing move which threatens something. 3. Develop knights before bishops. 4. Pick the most suitable square for a piece and develop it there once and for all. Or do not move your piece twice without a strong reason. 5. Make one or two pawn moves in the opening, not more. 6. Do not bring your queen out early. 7. Castle as soon as possible, preferably on the king's side. 8. Play to get control of the center. 9. Always try to maintain at least one pawn in the center. 10. Do not sacrifice without a clear reason. 11. Complete your development before you attack. 12. Pay attention to your opponent's moves. 13. Avoid exchanging bishops for knights. And rule number 14, fight for space. Now let's take a look at the following chess master's game. E4, rule number 1. E5, knight c3. Developing the knight before bishops, rule number 3. This opening is called Vienna game. Knight c6, also developing the knight before bishops. F4, attacking the e5 pawn with a pawn. This is actually a pawn sacrifice. This opening is called Vienna gambit. A gambit is an opening where one player gives up material with the intention of securing an advantage in time or space. In Vienna gambit, the attack is directed against the most vulnerable square in Black's camp, f7. The White's f pawn is used to weaken Black's hold in the center. If Black takes the pawn, accepting the gambit, White tries to regain the pawn later on, after having first secured a permanent advantage in the center. If Black wishes to hold on the material, he must submit to a backward development. The best way to meet the gambit is to accept the sacrifice and then concentrating on speedy development, if necessary, returning the extra material. In many cases, White's compensation for the pawn is a strong center, or more effective development. In this game, Black takes the f4 pawn. This is one of the few cases where Black can effort to hold on to his material. The reason is that the development of the c3 knight is not particularly favorable in the king's gambit. Knight f3, developing the knight. G5, D4, G4, attacking the knight on f3. Bishop c4, sacrificing the knight. This variation is called Pierre's gambit. Pawn takes knight. Bishop takes pawn on f4, developing the bishop. In this position, black, a very strong player, makes a mistake. Pawn takes pawn on g2, attacking the rook on h1. This is actually the only black's mistake in this game. Better was bishop g7, developing the bishop. Pawn takes pawn was played. White plays bishop takes pawn on f7 check, sacrificing the bishop. King takes bishop, queen h5 check, king to g7. If king to e7, can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. The first move is knight d5 check, king e6, the only move. If you didn't find mate in two, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen f5 check mate. And if king to e6, can you find mate in three in this position? Please pause the video. The first move is queen f5 check, king e7, the only move. If you didn't find mate in three, can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. Knight d5 check, king e8, the only response. If you didn't find mate in two, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen h5 check mate. Let's go back to the game. King to g7 was played. Rook g1, a winning move. Knight g to e7. Bishop h6 check, king to g8. If king to f6 then follows. Queen f3, check. King to e6. If king to g6. Can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. Rook takes pawn on g2, check. King takes h6, the only move. If you didn't find mate in two, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 5 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen h3, checkmate. Mate with queen and rook. Let's go back. After king to e6 follows d5, check. King to d6. e5, check. Knight takes pawn on e5. If king takes pawn on e5, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen f4, checkmate. Let's go back. After knight takes pawn on e5, follows queen f6, check. King c5, the only move. Now, can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. The first move is bishop e3, check. King to b4. If king to c4, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen f4, checkmate. Let's go back. After king to b4, can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. A3, check. King to a5. If you didn't find mate in two, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. B4, checkmate. A pawn mate. Let's go back to the game. King to g8 was played. Now, can you find mate in 3 in this position? Please pause the video. The first move is rook takes pawn on g2, check. In this position, black actually resigned. It could follow bishop g7. If knight g6, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 10 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen d5, check mate. Let's go back to the game. Bishop g7. Rook takes bishop, check. King f8, the only move. Can you find mate in one in this position? You have 5 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Queen f7, checkmate. Mate with queen and rook. Now let's take a look at the following chess master's game. E4, rule number one. E5, knight c3, developing the knight before bishops. Rule number three. Vienna game. Knight f6, developing the knight. F4, attacking the e5 pawn with a pawn. This is actually a pawn sacrifice. D5, attacking the e4 pawn. The best response. Pawn takes pawn on e5, attacking the knight. Knight takes pawn on e4. Knight f3, developing the knight. Bishop to g4, developing the bishop and pinning the knight on f3. An old but playable continuation. Nevertheless, modern theory considers to bishop e7, developing the bishop to be sounder, followed by the rapid development of the king's side. Let's go back to the game. Bishop g4 was played. Queen e2, attacking the knight on e4 with two pieces. Knight c5. This is not the best move. Black makes too many moves with the knight. Rule number four. Do not move your piece twice without a strong reason. Knight takes knight on c3 is the simplest here. For example, pawn d2 takes knight on c3, c6 with equal chances. Let's go back to the game. Knight c5 was played. D4, attacking the knight and at the same time setting a trap. Bishop takes knight on f3. Retreating the knight to e6 was better. Queen takes bishop. Queen h4, check. A double attack. G3. Queen takes pawn on d4, winning a pawn. Bishop e3, sacrificing a second pawn in order to open lines. Queen takes pawn on e5, pinning the bishop on e3. White castles queen side, attacking the d5 pawn with three pieces. C6, defending the d5 pawn. Now white is ahead in development, which enables him to sacrifice a knight. Knight takes pawn on d5. Pawn takes knight. Rook takes pawn on d5, attacking the queen. Queen to e6. If queen to e4, attacking the white's queen, then follows bishop b5 check, knight c6. After king e7, can you find mate in 3 in this position? Please pause the video. The first move is bishop takes knight on c5 check. King e6, the only response. Queen takes queen check. King f6, the only move. Queen f5, checkmate. Let's go back. After knight c6, follows. Bishop takes knight on c5, sacrificing the queen. Queen takes queen. Bishop takes knight on c6, check. The bishop has to be taken. Rook e1, check. Bishop e7. Now, can you find mate in 3 in this position? Please pause the video. Rook takes bishop on e7, check. King f8, the only move. If you didn't find mate in 3, can you find mate in 2 in this position? Please pause the video. Rook takes pawn on a7, discovered check. Black king has two moves. After king to e8, can you find mate in 1 in this position? You have 5 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Rook takes rook on a8, checkmate. And if king to g8, can you find mate in 1 in this position? You have 5 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Rook takes rook, checkmate. Let's go back to the game. Queen to e6 was played. Bishop to c4. Queen e4, attacking the white's queen and the bishop on c4. Bishop takes knight on c5, a queen sacrifice. which forces Black's immediate resignation in this position. In this position, Black actually resigned. On queen takes queen, there follows rook e1, check, bishop e7. Can you find mate in two in this position? Please pause the video. Rook takes bishop on e7, check. King f8, the only move. If you didn't find mate in two, can you find mate in one in this position? You have 5 seconds for it. Please pause the video. Rook d8, check mate. Okay, that's the lesson for today from the Eugene Greenius Chess School. I hope it was useful and you enjoyed it. If so, push likes, subscribe to my YouTube channel and leave comments. And the last question for today. Did you find an Easter egg in this video? This is another interesting video for you. Firstly, you can always find it in the video description. And secondly, you can catch it in the last 10 seconds of the video. Thanks for watching.